Hello and welcome to this Design Cuts video tutorial, and today we're looking at styles in Photoshop. Chances are you've already got some experience with styles because you will have applied effects to text and to shapes in Photoshop. So when I click here on the effects icon and click drop shadow, I can apply a drop shadow to my text. So I'm just going to adjust this a little bit. Let's make it a little bit bigger and a little bit further away from the text. I have a kind of nice little drop shadow here. Well, if I wanted to use that over and over again without having to come in and make settings available, I can save that as a style. I do that by clicking the new style icon, which really should be the save this as a new style icon, because that's what you're doing. You're setting it up first and then saving it. And I'm going to call this drop shadow for text. And I'll just click OK. It's now saved as a style in Photoshop, so I can use it anytime in the future. So I'm just going to click OK. Let's turn that layer off. Let's turn a different text layer on. And if I want to apply my style to it, what I can do is just target this layer and go to the FX icon. I'm just going to select one of these options because it's really not clear how you get to the styles from here, but you'll just select something. Because up here are the styles that are available, and we're going to click on this one, which is our drop shadow style. What happened was that all the other options that were turned on are now disabled, and all we're seeing is the drop shadow that I asked to see. But here in this dialog, you can see that there are other styles available. So for example, we can click any of these to apply them to our text. And there are heaps of different styles that you can apply to your text. They can also be applied to shapes. So let's just go and target a shape and let's go to the same FX icon. We'll choose something. It doesn't matter what, because we're going to the styles, because now we can get access to these styles and apply them with a single click to our object. These are the default styles that come with Photoshop. And of course, my style has been tagged on to the very end. Now there are other styles that are shipped with Photoshop. If you click the gear icon, you'll see the styles that are shipped with Photoshop. Now, all of these, except for the leather styles, are shipped with Photoshop. So there are some text effects, there are textures, web styles, a whole heap of styles that you can get access to. If you want to, you're just going to click on the style. You'll probably want to append them because you'll want them to be added to the current styles list, and then they'll be available too. And you can just click on any of them to apply them to your object. Now, if you apply a style to an object and you think it's possibly not as good as you expected it to be, sometimes the problem is the scale. If I right-click this style area and choose Scale Effects, I can scale the style. So I could take it down to 50% and that would push it further towards the edges of the shape. With other styles, that might change the look of the style a little bit, and you're looking for, say, something better than what you're seeing at the moment. You can also enlarge it, so we're just going to take this out to about 200%, and you can see that it has a different look when it is scaled larger. So always be aware that when you get styles, if they don't look as good as you thought they should, try scaling them. Now I've got this style applied to this shape here. I'm going to right click it and I can copy the layer style. That allows me to copy it and put it somewhere else. Well, let's go back to our Dreamer text. I'm just going to turn this off. I'm going to right click and choose Paste Layer Style. And that layer style is now pasted onto my Dreamer's text. Notice too that in the process that the layer style didn't have any drop shadow in it. I had a drop shadow applied to this text, but I've lost it because the layer style has replaced the existing one. So just be aware of that. Now at this point you might be wondering that since we're here for Design Cuts, maybe Design Cuts has layer styles too. And of course the answer is yes. So let's head to the website and see what's available. I started at Design Cuts and I typed in Photoshop styles, and these are some of the products that we have that include Photoshop styles. The ones we're going to look at are the leather styles, but there are also things like couture glitter and there are metal stamping ones. In fact, you'll find that there are heaps and heaps of wonderful, downloadable, usable layer styles for Photoshop. So let's go and have a quick look at the leather ones. I'm going back to my cowboy text, and now I want to delete these layer styles, so I'm just going to drag and drop them onto the trash can. Now with the text selected, let's go back to the styles area. I'm going to append my leather style, so here they are here in the list. When you download and install your styles, you're going to have to close Photoshop and reopen Photoshop for the styles to appear in the list. But if you don't do that, you can still load them. You'll just go to the Load Styles area and you'll have to navigate to wherever it is that you have the styles expanded into. Now, let's just go out of here for a second because I want to show you the location that you're going to put your styles in. It goes in your Program Files Adobe folder, and it goes in the location for whatever version of Photoshop you happen to be using. And styles have been around for years and years, so you're going to find them available for even much earlier versions of Photoshop. So just select your version and go to Preset Styles, and that's where you're going to put your styles file. So now that we've done that, let's just head back to the styles area and let's just have a quick look at these wonderful leather styles. Now these styles come with a whole heap of content, and you can see what content they come with because you're seeing here the options that are checked. They're the ones that are applied using this style. So there's a drop shadow, there's a pattern overlay, a gradient overlay. A whole heap of style features are being used to end up with this wonderful result. And so you can click on any of these to see what the styles look like. These can also be enlarged or reduced using that scale option. And down here is a really interesting one. I didn't quite expect to see denim in a leather styles collection, but it's there and it's just awesome. So I hope that you've enjoyed learning about styles in Photoshop. Let us know what you think in the comments below and give us a thumbs up if you enjoyed the tutorial. Until next time, I'm Helen Bradley for Design Cuts.